Hi, this is Kevin, KGM Jam owner, Pro Advertisers Club, a totally free site to advertise. Go to proadvertisersclub.com, join for free today, and start advertising for free. Okay, here we are, January the 5th, 24, a Friday, for the night, the daily DCA. And let me show you what I've been getting. If you've seen any of the past videos in a few days, let's go to my collection. But right now, I'm concentrating on core Golden Age comics. That's the core cover. That's an 8.50 or 8.5 rating for the shape that it's in. 2.0 is the uncommon, and then legendary is 10.0. So they kind of went backwards on the uncommon and the common, which is now called the core. And actually, the uncommon's pretty popular. You think it, sometimes these comics have writings on them and ripped pages on them and all sorts of stuff. But the difference between Candy and Veve, Candy's DC, Veve is Marvel. And Veve went the route of five different covers. The common's the original. The uncommon is the original, less a lot of color usually. And then the rare and ultra rare are exclusive covers just for Veve. And then the legendary can be either an exclusive or some other cover that they put out on an issue before. But it's all the same comic. The same thing on Candy is they're all the same comic, but they're all the same cover, but in different graded in conditions, okay? I choose the core and I stack 10. I get one for me, nine to flip, okay? And the I DCA $10 a day. That's sometimes I don't, but most of the times I do. And right now I've been picking up the Detective Comics number 58 for $5. $4, $6, and I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, plus the one I got on the drop, so 7. So I need about 3 more to get to my 10, and then I'll lay off of it. But so let's go see what they got today. But I, on Veve, they've only dropped one Golden Age comic that I know of, and that's Marvel number 1. And on Candy, though, they're dropping Golden comics left and right. And Golden comics are, and I'm not a professional comic book collector, but Golden Age is like in the 30s and 40s, old comics. Silver Age is in the 60s, around that, and then you got the age now that we're in. Even though they probably have an age for the 90s, and because that's, you're talking 20, 30 years ago already. But anyway, let's go look at the marketplace. I've got 10 comics up for sale. They're all my low mints. What I like to do with low mints is sell them and then take the money and rebuy the same issue but at a higher mint or the best price I can get for the lowest mint, and then use the extra money to invest in something else and all that. So here's all the ones I'm selling. None of them are sold yet, but I got them priced a little bit on the high side for what the regular comics are going for. But they're semi, you know, the lowest mint I got is 11, and that's the Aquaman right here, Aquaman. And then I've got the number 28 on the rare. That will probably go eventually, because that is a pretty low mint number, but it's not a super low, you know, like 10 or less, which would probably go immediately if I threw that up there, depending on what I priced it at. So let's go to sold and look what I like to look at the legendaries that are selling. That gives me a good idea. Rarity, legendary, apply and close. It gives me a good idea what the wells are doing, because, like, look at that price right there, $35 for that. That's an excellent price. $245 for Wonder Woman. $6,325. That was all today, guys. This has all been today. Superman number 1 Multiverse Edition, which is the same comic as the one above it, but it's just got a freaky deaky cover, and that's $169. But yeah, these Okay, they sold, wow, they sold two legendary Supermans today. Mint number 68 and mint number 121. That's somebody's throwing money at it because maybe they know something's coming. I don't know, but it's been a long time since two Superman number one legendaries have sold on the same day. Crisis on Infinite Earth sold. Batman number 609. Detective Comics 1059. For $1,280. Now that's that very low mint number comic, but that's not a Silver Age or a Golden Age by any means. But yeah, okay, so that's the last one. The last one so is Batman, and then Showcase here, number 22, the first appearance of the Green, the modern Green, whatever his name is, I can't remember, Jordan, I think, or something like that. But all right, so let's go get my pick for tonight. So, I need to go back here to, let's go back to the market. Let's see if I can do it that way. Yeah, I want to go first sell, and I want to go to rarity and go to core, and then go down here to price and go under $10. Apply and close. And then what I'm going to do is go to high to low, because the Golden Age is most of them will be that comic on the top there. That's $10. It's a core, but it's very low mint. There's only 416 of them. Very low mint. Now here's the first one for $9.99, All-American Comics number 16. That is the first appearance of the Green Lantern, and I will be stacking those. But I think I can get a better deal. $8.75 for All-Star Comics. That's the first I get together of the Justice League, I believe. Wiz Comics, number two, first appearance of Captain Marvel, Shazam. Detective Comics, number 140, first appearance of the Riddler. Sensation Comics, number one. It's, I think, her first origin, or I don't think it's her first appearance, though, but it's a Golden Age and it's a grail, whatever it is. We'll look at it if we have to. More Fun Comics. First, this is a double whammy in this issue. Number one, our first appearance of Green Arrow and first appearance of Aquaman. And that's only for $6.99. And then here's the one I've been stocking up at $6.80. I've been getting them for $5 or less, but they're drying up because I've gotten the last six of them. So I've got enough of those. I'm going to go and let's go back. And again, all these comics are good, but I'm just interested in certain ones right now. So what I think I'm going to do, I need to stock up on that All-American comic. I am going to go ahead and get that. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to look at which one's got the lowest, the lowest mint number. Okay, that one's 823. This one's 735. That one's 1,821. 1,185. They're all pretty high. Okay. 1,006 for 7. I am going to get this one, and I'll do it off screen, and so you don't see my personal information. If you get a chance, like and subscribe. Go check out Pro Advertisers Club, and if you haven't joined Candy yet, join. It's for free, and start collecting, because I was talking about this in my VV video, but we don't know what's going to happen from day to day, but as, and this is not financial advice, entertainment purposes only, listen to me at your own risk, but if NFTs are going to take off, I think these platforms that I'm promoting, that I participate on, are going to be some of the winners. And of course, if anything ever popped up that I thought that wasn't the case, I'd say it right away. But from what we know now, But, you know, DC can change their mind. Disney could change their mind. The companies could, either they're owned by DC and Marvel, or they're, you know, so many things can happen and things that we don't know about. That's what can change. But as of right now, and with the prices that these are at, because remember, you buy low and sell high, okay? And most, if you've studied anybody who does well in markets, they buy when nobody else wants to buy, and they sell when everybody's buying because they're chasing the top, you know? And it's a pretty basic formula, but you got to be patient. And I think right now, can these prices get lower? I don't know how they could. I really don't know. As low mint as these candy DC comics are, that there's not that many people willing to let them go at this price. I just don't see it. We're talking 2,000 or less mints on the core, that which is incredibly a small amount of mints when shit hits the fan. So to put it in perspective, and of course this doesn't indicate anything, but I think the Superman, the first one they dropped, its core is going for about 300 to 400 on any given day right now. And it's got about the same mints. It might have more mints, actually, than these. They cut back 1,000 or 2,000 on the mints. So the point I'm making is, I think that represents the true value of these core Golden Age comics, because of the first appearances, the age of them, that they represent, because these are NFTs. And so I think these cores are actually more aching to be between $200 to $400 eventually. Now, is that tomorrow, 5 years from now? I don't know. Because they're going to keep dropping comics. They're going to keep dropping Golden Age comics. And a lot of the prices are down simply because it's so saturated. There's nothing. Everybody's always selling to get the next drop. Because on these drops, if you get a legendary, you can sell it for $200, $300, $1,000. Depends on, you know, which comic it is. And that's pretty much what all the platforms are doing. They're just constantly dropping stuff. So you really never have a chance to, you just got to have a strategy and you got to stick to it. Otherwise you're going to get eaten alive and make mistakes. So anyway, please like and subscribe. Have a good night. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you tomorrow.